James, and today's guest is Dr. Valcavi from Italy. Dr. Valcavi, welcome.
Thank you.
It's great to have you here today. It's an interesting topic we're going to discuss. We're doing an RFA, radiofrequency ablation tutorial, the six steps to go into the procedure, and it's really an honor to have you here, Dr. Valcavi, because you're a well-known practitioner in this space. So it's really, really an honor to have you here. Welcome. Where are you in Italy?
I'm in Reggio, Emilia. Reggio, Emilia is northern Italy.
Mm-hmm. Well, let's jump into the six steps, the tutorial here. And you said the first step is the setup of the patient. So if you could please describe the setup of the patient.
Yeah, the setup of the patient is in an operatory room. I don't like the ambulatory setting because of safety. The safety of an operatory room is by far greater than the setting of an ambulatory room. So I know that I'm aware that there are two parties, one for the ambulatory setting and one is for the operatory room. I'm for the second one because the safety is much greater. And starting from the setup, the setup is made by the anesthesiologist who takes a forearm vein and takes all vital parameters and puts on the protecting goggles and the nasal oxygen cannula. And thereafter, a sterile field is made. This is very important, a sterile field, because since I did more than 1,800 procedures, I didn't have any single infection.
How many RFA procedures have you done?
1,800.
1,800?
Yes, that's right. That's right.
And how long have you been?
In 20 years.
You've been doing RFA for 20 years?
I did the laser first, and I moved to the radiofrequency in 2010. I did the laser since 2000, and I moved to the radiofrequency in 2010. And by far, is better radiofrequency. Radiofrequency, I prefer by far, since patient number one, I was for radiofrequency.
And you're using RFA for what type of procedures? What type of nodules?
I use for benign nodules, for cystic nodules, for hyperfunctioning nodules, benign nodules. And this is the new frontier. I use radiofrequency for malignant micro-papillary tumors. This is very important because up to now, this is the new application for RFA. This is very effective according to literature, to Asian literature. And we started in Europe and, as far as I know, in the United States too.
Okay, well, back to the six steps. So the patient, there's a setup. You get the setup done for the patient. Then there's the anesthesia.
The anesthesiologist does the preparation. In fact, the only thing that I do is local anesthesia, ultrasound-guided local anesthesia, and with lidocaine, with a mixture of lidocaine plus ropivacaine. The mixture allows short-term and long-term protection. It is done pericapsular. It's very important to do it pericapsular because the nerve termination are very, the sensitivity of thyroid capsule is very high. So anesthesia, pericapsular anesthesia is very important in order to have the patient the most comfortable. And after that, the anesthesiologist gives, before doing local anesthesia, he gives some fentanyl and midazolam, which are, fentanyl is an opioid, is a painkiller, and midazolam, which is a benzodiazepine, is a sedation drug. And after that, he does an infusion with propofol. Propofol is an hypnotic drug. Propofol causes a slight depression, so we give oxygen, breathing depression. So we give oxygen in order to maintain normal oxygen saturation in the blood. We monitor, of course, all vital parameters, including oxygen in the blood.
Great. So step number one is the patient setup. Step number two, we're preparing for anesthesia. And then step number three is the electrode needle insertion.
Step three is insertion of the needle. It is done at the point, exactly at the point, transistorically, so with a transverse approach, exactly in a point, in the point where previously a local anesthesia has been done. This is being marked with a marker pen.
Very good. And then there's some preparation in regard to the laryngeal nerve.
Yes, the laryngeal nerve is the most delicate point. The laryngeal nerve may be cooled with glucose, with cold glucose. I use cold glucose infusion. I drink too, if you permit.
Cheers.
Laryngeal nerve is in the danger triangle. We call it the danger triangle, is posterior. And exactly, there is the risk with radiofrequency procedure when nodules are posterior, are in the back of the neck, to have injury of the laryngeal nerve, which moves the vocal cord. And this is the most dangerous side effect, which can occur with standard surgery as well. There is a difference between surgery. In standard surgery, the laryngeal nerve can be cut. So when the laryngeal nerve is cut, there is nothing to repair it. And when the laryngeal nerve gets some heating by radiofrequency, then it can recover.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's good news. You know, I had a thyroidectomy and they cut my laryngeal nerve and paralyzed my vocal cord. and I ended up having to get a vocal cord implant. So that's no fun. None of that is fun. It's nice to hear that RFA is a safe procedure and we're not paralyzing vocal cords.
Yes.
Let's go over the steps again. Number one, we're going to set up the patient. Number two, anesthesia setup and administer. Number three, we're going to do the electrode needle insertion and ablation. And then we're going to have the laryngeal nerve hydrodissection. And then five, here we are, the electrode needle extraction and compression. Please tell us about step number five.
Yes, extraction is very simple. Simply take out the needle. But at the same time, it must be used compression. This simple maneuver avoids bleeding, both internal and external bleeding. External bleeding is not a major side effect. Internal bleeding must be maybe a major side effect. So with compression, applying compression, hard compression for 3 to 5 minutes, avoid all bleeding. I didn't have any bleeding since I used this simple maneuver.
Fantastic. And then the last step, you do a final check of the patient. What do you mean by
yes.
The final check?
A final check means that I check the ablation obtained with radio frequency. Maybe you have some images of micro-papillary tumors that I ablated recently. In these cases, there were two micro-papillary tumors that were ablated in the same time, and I checked, I passed the probe upon the neck of the patient, and I used the micro-V, which is a function of my Esaote ultrasound equipment. And the micro-V is an interesting device. It's almost a contrast media device, which shows exactly the ablated area. So with that device, I check exactly where and the extent, where the ablated area is and the extent of the ablated area.
Dr. Valcavi, as we come to an end here, and there's patients listening to this interview from all around the world, they may be wondering how to find a doctor who provides RFA treatment. Where can they go to find a doctor who provides RFA treatment?
Oh, yes. They can go on rfamd.com. They will click on rfamd.com, and they will find a map of doctors doing RFA around the world.
Yeah, great. And we saw your listing there also. So yeah, for patients looking for a doctor who does RFA treatment around the world, rfamd.com. Any final words, Dr. Valcavi, before we say farewell?
Final word is that my favorite quote is, do RFA surgery, you will save your thyroid gland.
It's so important too. And I can say this because I had thyroidectomy, and once the thyroid gland is gone, life does change, and it's not usually for the better. So I 100% agree with your quote. Thank you so much.
Okay. Thank you.